हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ सब्जेक्ट हाईवे इंजीनियरिंग. इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्ट द यूनिट नंबर 2 ऑफ हाईवे इंजीनियरिंग, दैट इज ज्योमेट्रिक डिजाइन ऑफ हाईवे. दिस यूनिट इज फॉर 16 मार्क. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैड डिस्कस्ड द डेफिनेशन ऑफ ज्योमेट्रिक डिजाइन ऑफ हाईवे. व्हाट इज मीन बाय ज्योमेट्रिक डिजाइन ऑफ हाईवे? द फेस ऑफ हाईवे विच कैन बी डील्स with the visible elements of different highways such as alignment, side distance, etc. is called geometric design of highway. Then next point, we had seen that the points which can be should be kept in view while doing the geometric design of highway. Then next point is important highways term. This point is also we had started last lecture, that is the important terms which is used in highway or which is used in highway engineering. The first term which is used for highway is right of way. This is we can discuss in previous lecture. Right of way means the area of land acquired for construction and development of road along its alignment is called as a right of way. Then next is road margin. This is also we had seen in last lecture. Then roadway width, that is the total width of road. Then carriage way, the portion of road way constructed for movement of vehicular traffic is called as a carriage way or pavement or crust. This is also seen in last lecture. Now in this lecture we are going to discuss the next term of highway, that is a shoulder. Now see the definition of shoulder. The portion of roadway between the outer edge of pavement and edges of top surface of embankment or inner edges of the side drain in cutting are known as the shoulders. Now see what is the shoulder. The road portion of roadway between outer edge of pavement and edge of the top surface of embankment is called as the shoulder. Now see one figure which can be show the shoulder. It is the shoulder. It is the portion between the outer edge of pavement and edge of surface embankment. It is the outer edge of pavement and it is the edge of embankment, and the portion between this is shoulder. That is the side distance of road is also known as shoulders. This shoulder is of 6 foot. Now see, it is the shoulder. The distance of road from this white border is called as a shoulder. The shoulder is provided along the road edge to serve an emergency lane for vehicle compelled to be taken out pavement of road. That is, when the traffic is heavy or in emergency, we are use shoulders for move the vehicle from roads or from roads to go or to move. The shoulders are used. Shoulders also act as service lane for breakdown vehicles. It is the service lane to the breakdown vehicles. That is, when any vehicle is breakdown, then we can keep it on the shoulder of road. Now this chart gives the width of shoulder as per IRC, that is as per Indian Road Congress, the width of shoulders in meter. First is for plain areas and second is for hilly areas. The national and state highways with single lane has the width on plain areas is 4.125 meter and in hilly areas it's 1.25 meter. Then two lane national and state highways with two lane it is a 2.5 meter for plain area and 0.90 meter for hilly areas. Now second is major district roads. For plain area with single lane the width is 2.625 meters, for hilly areas it is a 0.5 meter, and two lane major district roads it is a 1 meter, and in hilly areas the two lane roads are not provided. Now other district roads with single lane in plain areas the shoulder width is 1.875 meter, in hilly areas it is a 0.5 meter, and two lane other district roads with two lane on plain area it is a 1 meter, and for hilly areas two lane roads are not provided. Now for village areas the shoulder width for plain area is 2.25 meter and for hilly area is 0.5 meter. Hope you all get the width of shoulder. Now next term of highway is side slopes. Now see what is a side slope. The slope given to the side of earthwork of a road in embankment or in cutting for its stability is called as a side slope. That is the slope which can be provided for stability of roads is called as a side slope. Now see, it is a side slope of road. We can see in this image at this pole it is the slope is provided. This is road and at the edge of road slope is provided to give the stability of this road. This slope is called as a side slope. It is a side slope. Then see the details of side slope. If the embankment filling, that is the height of embankment or the total height of material which can be used for construction of road is embankment. The height of embankment is over 0.8 meter, then slope is 2:1. Then the filling material subsoil strata consists of heavy clay. The material used for the filling have heavy clay, then the slope is 2:1. Then the height of embankment is more than 3 meter and subject to weathering, then it is a 2.1. Then for cutting, it is for filling, then for cutting the ordinary soil the slope is 1:1 or 1.5:1. Then the material is disintegrated rock, then the slope is 1.5:1 or 1/4:1. Then for soft rock and shale the slope is 1/4:1 or 1/8:1. Then for medium rock the slope is 1/12:1 to 1/60:1. And for hard rock the slope is nearly vertical. Now see, this is the value of slopes for embankment filling and for cutting. Now see what is filling. Filling means the when road is constructed we have to fill the materials for construction, and cutting means while constructing road we have to cut the material or cut the soil of surface. It is a cutting, that is we have to remove the extra material on the land while constructing a road. It is a cutting. Now next term is berms. Now see what is a berms. The portion of land width left in between the toe of road embankment and the inner edge of barrow pit is called as the berms, or the portion in between the top edge of road cutting and the nearest edge of soil bank on either side are known as the berms. That is, now see the figure for clear. It is the portion between toe of the embankment and inner edge of barrow pit. Here the barrow pit is constructed. The inner edge of barrow pit and the toe of embankment, the portion between this is called as a berm. Now next is spoil bank. The bank constructed for surplus excavated earth on the side of road cutting parallel to its alignment are known as spoil banks. In other words, when the excavated earth is not completely required for the forming the road embankment, in such case the extra earth is deposited in the form of small banks, which are known as spoil banks. Spoil means the material which not is used for construction. Surplus means the extra excavated material. That while constructing the roads, we have some extra material which is not required for construction. These material are placed parallel to the alignment of road, and this is known as a spoil bank. Then next is barrow pits. What is meant by barrow pits? The pits dug along alignment of road for using their material in construction of embankment are known as barrow pits. That is, what is meant by barrow pits? The barrow pits are dug along the alignment of road for using the material in the construction. Barrow pits should be dug at least 5 meters away from toe of embankment. Now see, it is a barrow pit. The material from barrow pit is used for construction of the road. Now see, this is a road, total road, and from the road, the distance from road or away from road on the 5 meters, we can constructed barrow pits, and the material from these pits are used for construction of roads. Now next is curbs. Now see what is curbs. The boundaries between the pavement and shoulder or footpath is known as the curbs. Now see, the boundaries between the boundaries between the pavement and shoulder or footpath is known as a curbs. It is the boundaries between the pavement and footpath is known as a curbs. See, this is white and black is curbs. Now see the types of curbs. There are variety of curbs designed. Curbs may be divided into 3 groups based on their function. First is lower mountable type curbs or curbs. This type of curbs which throw encourage traffic to remain in the traffic lanes, yet allow the driver to enter the shoulder area with little difficulty. That is, the lower mountable type curbs are encourage the traffic to remain in traffic lanes. That is, by using these curbs, the traffic is not allowed to go outside from the roads. Then next is semi barrier type curbs. This is provided on the periphery of a roadway where the pedestrian traffic is high. When the pedestrian traffic is high, then this type of curb is used. This type of curb has a height about 50 cm, about 15 cm above the pavement edge, with a batter of 1:1 on the top 7.5 cm. Then next is barrier type curb or curb. This is provided in built-up areas adjacent to the footpath with considerable pedestrian traffic. Now see, this is a mountable curb which has shape like that and the distance is 10 cm. Then it is a semi-barrier type curb. It has more height, that is 15 cm. It is a barrier type curb, that is a, it has a function to vary the vehicles go out from the roads. It has a height 20 cm and it is also one another type of curb is submerged curb. That is the curb is constructed under the roads. Now next is formation level. The next term is formation level. The reduced level of finished surface of artwork for a road in embankment or cutting is known as the formation level. That is, while constructing roads, to make the finished surface, we have to cut the material which is extra on the surface, or we have to fill the material which is at lower surface. Then this filling the material or cutting the material to make the finished surface is called as a formation level. Hope you all get these terms related to highway. Now in next lecture we are see the next term related to highway. Now see, from first lecture we had discussed these terms related to highway. Just remember these terms and meaning of these terms, and out of these 10 or maybe it is a 50 terms, out of these 10 or 15 terms we are just, or maybe there is a only one or two or three terms which can be asked in the exam for 4 marks, or we just have to remember these terms. That is, without these terms we are not going to get the concept of highways or the construction of highways. For the construction of all types of road and for the construction of all highways, we have to know these terms of highways. Now see, in this lecture first we had see the shoulders of highways. This is the shoulder of highway. It is the portion of roadway between the outer edge of pavement and edge of top surface of embankment is called a shoulder. Then next is side slope. That is, a slope is given to the side of roads for the stability of road is called a side slope. Then after side slope, next is berms. The portion of land width left between the toe of road embankment and the inner edge of barrow pit. That is the portion from toe of embankment of road and inner edge of barrow pit is called berms. It is the berms of road. Now next is spoil banks. The bank constructed from surplus, means extra excavated earth on the side of road cutting parallel to its alignment is called as a spoil bank. Next is barrow pit. The pit dug along alignment of road for using their material in construction of embankment are known as barrow pits. That is, the pits which can be constructed or which can be dug at the site of road, and the material or the soil or rocks from these pits are used for construction of roads. It is a barrow pits. Then next is curbs. The boundaries between pavement and shoulder or footpath are known as a curbs. It is a boundary between the pavement and the footpath, and this is known as a curb. Now see the types of curbs. First is lower mountable type curb, second is semi barrier type curb, third is barrier type curb. Then next is formation level. The reduced level of finished surface of earthwork of road in embankment or cutting is known as formation level. Hope you all get these terms related to highways. Now the next term we are seeing in the next lecture. Thank you.